We're back. Hey everyone. So we're back today, tonight. It's actually 7:03, 3 minutes late. But tonight we're doing a get ready with me, college edition, going out tonight, Saturday. So I'm gonna take you guys through my little Saturday night routine. And yeah, we're gonna do makeup, outfit, hair, the whole thing, and you guys will get to see kind of what I do and what I like to wear out and how I like to do my makeup out and what I do for my hair. And then we'll do a final look and we'll see how you guys like it. I have my little music going on in the background. Hopefully you guys can still hear me, but I can't just get ready without some música. I'm currently obsessed with Gunna's new song, One Call. I have like this great, I don't even know what to call it, like habit. I have this great habit, it's not so great, where I find a new song and then I become obsessed with it and then I play it 24/7 and then I get sick of it in like 2 days. So we're still going strong with Gunna, but that song will be dead and gone in like a couple hours maybe. But yes, so hopefully you guys can still hear me. We're gonna hop right into the makeup. This is my little bow that I like to wear to keep my hair back. I laugh at myself every time I see it because I look like a present. Alright. Here we go. So I've been using the Maybelline Fit Me Dewy and Smooth Foundation. It's a drugstore brand. I've been using that recently. I just started using it like this year. Not like as in like 2019, but like this year at school, I guess you could say, because I don't wear makeup during the summer. I only really wear makeup on the weekends when I go out. So I bought two shades. I have 210. You can see. Focus, please. There we go. 210 is the lighter shade I use. And then 230, same exact foundation, just a darker shade. I mix the two, so if I'm like weaning off my tan, I'll use like more 210. If I have like a fresh new tan now, I'll use like more of the 230, but I mix a little bit. So that's what we're gonna do. So I used quite a bit of the 230 because my tan is, I put it on like an hour ago. I use Saint Tropez. If you guys want to see like a tan routine, let me know. I am quite adamant about my tan. Just like crap all over this. So I just mix like a tiny bit of the 210. Mostly 230, you can see on the back of my hand, my little concoction. And then also a BB cream. There we go. This is just a Garnier, again, drugstore brand BB cream. This is primarily moisturizer, but it has a little bit of color in it. So, like I said, especially in the winter, I like using this because my skin gets so dry. So I just mix that in the back of my hand, and before we go on with the foundation, I'm gonna contour with a cream contour. I do cream contour as well as powder contour, just because I lay the cream contour under my foundation, so there's like a full face of just contoured whatever, and then I go over with powder almost to like set my makeup. Kind of weird, I don't know, I've really like never seen anyone else do that, but I like it, it gives me good results. So my contour palette is the ABH in Light Contour Cream Kit. You can see she's pretty busted. I've had this for so long, like I can't even, like many years, like it's probably expired, which is disgusting, but well, so I just go in, cream contour, or like cream products in general tend to dry up. So I go in with my Mario Badescu rose water. Come on. There we go. I need another one, but I go into with that in the two shades right here, and then I just mix them together once again. Like I said, this just kind of like makes the product a little more creamy. I'm currently doing this in my viewfinder. It's not gonna be good. So I go in right on my cheekbones, and then I go around my hairline, and I push this literally into my hair because my scalp is so much more pale than my face will be. So I usually look a little crazy if I don't push it into my hairline. I go all the way around my forehead, and then under my jaw to look snatched to the gods. That jawline is everything. And then the most important, the nose. I have struggled with insecurities pertaining to my nose ever since I can remember. I've been blessed with my father's Roman nose, thanks Dad, but not the cutest. So this is how I get the nose job I've always dreamed of. The contour's done. I look a little crazy, but we're gonna go in and just even everything out with my foundation concoction that I've had sitting on the back of my hand that whole time. It's nice and dark. So I'm using a Morphe M439 brush. Come on. There we go. I didn't say the other brush I used. This is just a Real Techniques. I got this in like a set, like a brush set. It's just like an angled brush that's covered in my contour. Probably should wash that. But yeah, I love Real Technique brushes. I've never been like I buy not designer, what is it called? Just like not drugstore makeup. Like higher, like just like Tarte and like other like Ulta brands that aren't like drugstore. But I've never been into like dropping bills on brushes. I don't know why. Okay, so now that we have the full base done, I go in with a little bit of under eye powder. Like I said, if I use a lot of this and I bake, I'll just crack. So I have to just use like the tiniest little bit. I'll use like this side of my beauty blender and go in. I'm just using the Laura Mercier setting powder, the translucent powder. I think there's only one shade. Translucent, yeah. I think there's only one shade. If I'm wrong, I'm very sorry. I'm not gonna show you guys because I think there's only one shade, but like I said, I use the tiniest amount for both my under eyes just because it's such a good setting powder that if you use a ton, I'll crack. I went in with a little bit more for my chin and my forehead. One thing I have noticed about this foundation after wearing it a lot is that it does oxidize. That's like one of the bad things about drugstore foundation is the chemical reaction with the oxygen on your skin and then like the chemicals they use in the foundation cause like oxidation, it's called. And the product, it just like, it lifts on my skin. It gets kind of like oily, kind of gross. And it changes color, like it'll definitely get darker throughout the night, which is weird, but it just happens. I'm gonna be in a dark room anyway, and I'll be taking it off in like 3 hours, so it's not a huge deal. I'm not too worried about it, but like during the day, sometimes it can be bad. But I never wear makeup during the day anyway. Like I roll out of bed and go to class, so it doesn't even really matter. But okay, so now that I'm set in my under eyes, I'm gonna go in with bronzer. So I use the Hoola bronzer by Benefit. There's only one shade. There's a dark, this is like their dark shade, and then there's a light shade. I go in with this and quite a bit of it, you can see. I have my backup right here waiting for me as soon as I run out. Go in with a pretty gentle amount and go in with my cheeks. I'm gonna be blending, so do not fear the harsh line right now. I would never go out with just a line like this. So now I have like the contour I just did, and I'm gonna use this, I got this in my Ipsy bag back when I was subscribed to that. NMOD. Never even heard of that. It's just like a compact. I think it actually may be a blush brush, but I use it to blend out my contour, my powder contour. So I'm just gonna go in and blend this out in a circular motion. I have to blend it really well because I did put a ton on. So this kind of sets like my cheek foundation and kind of enhances my contour, my cream contour that I did with my base, because that kind of gets like blended in with my foundation, so it's not as like prominent. It does make like a little bit of a difference, but adding the powder just like completes the contour. So now I'm going in with the Legendary e.l.f. brush. Ooh, I'm it's just a huge blush brush, and I'm gonna go in with my Tarte blush. I have a couple of these. I've never been like a huge blush girl, but I watch a lot of Jaclyn Hill, and she's always said like blush is like essential to your makeup routine, and if I don't wear it, I feel like I just look like, this is gonna sound bad, but like more fake. Like if I like just have bronzer, like I just look like there's no like color to my face, it's just like chiseled and whatever. So I just use a little bit of blush to like have some color in my face. So this is in the shade Feisty. It's like one of the Amazon clay brushes, Amazonian. I go in with a lot on the brush. Like I'm going in, it's not pigmented in the slightest. I just like use so little of it that I don't want to go in with like an actual good blush. I don't know, like I don't need a lot to like get the job done, so I just pack it on. Now I don't know what I'm doing. I will go in with my brows. So I like recently started doing this. It just kind of like, I don't know, I don't do anything to my eyebrows. I'm very blessed. I don't have to like use any like pencil or dip brow or anything like that. Like they're pretty full, so I just don't do anything. I put like a little gel in them to kind of keep them in place. But they're thick as fuck, and that's why I'm currently brushing through them to get all the product out of there. Otherwise they just like are caked to my face with the rest of my skin. So I just have to do this to get the dusted product out of there, like all the powders and stuff like that. So now they're pretty like clean as they will be. But I just kind of brush them up for now, and I'll go in with a little bit of Shape Tape on this tiny brush. This is a Real Techniques brush. This was in a set of eyeshadow brushes I got at Ulta. I think it was like $30. It came with like, I have them all right here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Came with like 4 brushes. $30, that's not that bad. So I'll take like literally just the top of the Shape Tape, and I'll go in with a little bit on my brush, and I'm just gonna carve like underneath. So I'll do like one on camera and then I will do the other one, so it's not like super boring. But I also need my eyebrows done desperately. I get my eyebrows done at Ulta, Sorry, that was so delayed, but I like need to focus. I got my eyebrows done at Ulta by my girl Sam. Love her. She's been doing my brows for like years. Probably like 2 or 3 years now. It's been a minute. But I refuse to let anyone else touch my brows. I had a huge brow glow up sophomore year, thanks to Sam. So it's been like 4 years. Jesus, it's a while. Maybe it was junior year, I forget. But anyway, she's the sole reason for my brows looking snatched, fleeky. Ew, I hated that. So shout out to Sam, but I need her desperately. So yeah, I don't know, you can kind of see I just like went in with the foundation, and I'm just gonna like pack the rest of the Shape Tape on top of my eye and use that as like an eyeshadow base. After I chiseled out the brows with the Shape Tape, I went in with my beauty blender and just kind of like buffed it out a little bit so it wasn't as harsh. But it does give like a nice like highlight underneath as well. So now I have not only a base, but they're kind of chiseled out a little bit. I don't know. I'm talking like I know what I'm doing and I don't. Okay, so I'm using, wow, I just completely was about to jump right into it and not say anything. So I use Sis Kylie. This is like one of her first palettes. This is quite old as well. I like used to just like go off, spend all my money on makeup, and I had like all like the newest like best stuff that was like everyone was talking about, and then I kind of just like fell off. Like I just stopped wearing a ton of makeup. I don't know what changed or like when it changed, but like I just wasn't as into makeup, and so I just like, I don't remember the last time I bought like the last time I bought new makeup was like the foundation, like the Maybelline foundation. That was literally at like CVS. Like I haven't bought anything. So we're using one of her OGs. I didn't even say what it was called. This is the Burgundy palette. So I'm going in right now on another Real Technique brush. This is part of like the eyeshadow set that I was talking about, that I got the little brush that I chiseled my eyebrows with. So I'm going in with the shade Beach right now, the middle one right here. It looks pretty dark, like it looked kind of dark on camera just now, but it's a really good transition shade. So I just set that down and I go in with this like pretty dense fluffy brush. And I just kind of buff it all over the place. Like I said, this is a good transition shade. So next, I just picked up a little bit of Burgundy and then the color Naked. Is that right? So hard, I don't get palette. Yeah, Naked. So it's the middle color and then this color. So I went in with both of them. And I'm just gonna kind of just do the same motion. Just go back and forth in my crease. Kind of do small circles, just blend it all together. This will give me some more color. I'm gonna go in with a little, like a tiny bit of almond. This shade right here. I'm actually gonna go in with this brush. It's literally gone forever and I need that brush. This is a Morphe eyeshadow brush. It's number 203. Can't really see, but bought it because it was spiky. I really didn't need this brush, but I'm gonna take like the tiniest little bit and just kind of do like a little V to make the corners darker, so it's kind of like a more like a smoky eye. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in with my under my lash line. I really, really like finishing this look because it's more like neutral on the top by putting that color Burgundy, like the bright pink, in the middle of the palette. This. I literally just stuck my whole entire finger in the eyeshadow. I'm sorry. This color right here in the middle, pink, I'm gonna go in with like a chiseled angle brush. Once again, this is the eyeshadow brush that I got in the Real Techniques package with like the other purple brushes. They're all purple, so if you see the purple brushes, they were all in a set. I got from Ulta. So I'm just gonna go in with a generous amount of product and just pack it under my lash line like so. This really just like, it makes my eyes, like the color of my eyes pop, because it's just, it's such a, I don't know, like it's just like a pop of color. It just makes it pop, and it also brings together the top, brings out that like the same color that I had put on my eye earlier, kind of brings it out some more so it looks a little more pink. The downside is though, trying to get this off my under eye, because I can't use with eyelash extensions. Probably should have mentioned that, but I have eyelash extensions, so I don't do anything to my eyes. Another reason why I don't wear any makeup during the week, because my skin is fairly good where I don't need like a skin makeup throughout the week, and the eyelashes are enough to like give me some life. Anyway, so we're gonna go in with that like spiky brush that I added the darker product on at the end of the eye look, just to buff this out. So I'm gonna get nice and uncomfortable. This is like the worst, and I probably look crazy, but this just kind of buffs it out. Oh wow, that's cute. That's a cute face. I guess it's equivalent to like a mascara face. A lot of beauty gurus have like a mascara face, or like when they do their mascara, they're looking crazy. I like can't control my face when I do this stuff, like it just happens. But since I don't have to do a mascara face, we're just gonna have this. Oh gosh, it's really uncomfortable. All right, so I don't think, you can kind of tell it's like, it's just brought further down. Okay, so now that I just had to fan my skin and kind of just let the setting spray like sink in and dry. So now I'm gonna do highlight. A lot of people do highlight before, with, and then set like everything together. I personally like a fresh highlight like on top of setting it. I don't set my highlight. I just found an eyelash extension in my drawer. I don't know if you can see. It really doesn't matter, but I find these shits everywhere. It's like when I used to have elastics, I used to have braces and I used to have elastics, and I would just like fling them out of my mouth when they snapped or when I was like eating, and my house was filled with elastics. It was disgusting. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with another Real Techniques brush. This is a setting brush, so this is for setting powder, for like under your eyes. I use it as a highlight. Works for me. I'm not a fan of those fan brushes, to be honest. I never found one that was like all the fan brushes that I saw or felt were really rough, and I just didn't want to pay for another brush because I'm a cheap fuck. So I just use a brush that I already have, and it works out well. So this is the ABH Glow Kit. This is That Glow. I don't know if that's what it's called. I'll just say the names of it, the colors I use. So I go in with Bubbly and Dipping Gold, so the two bottom ones. So I'm gonna go in with a little bit of those and just do the top of my cheekbone. You wanna highlight any like high points of your face. One thing with highlight, so everyone likes to just go in and be like shining to the gods, but if you have textured skin, too much highlight can actually break you, because it's supposed to draw attention and draw your eye there. So like if you put a light product over textured like a textured area, it'll be so much more prominent than if you just left it with foundation. So if or when I have breakouts, I usually skip highlight just because why would I want to draw any more attention to my skin? So I went in with Sunburst, this lighter shade. That was disgusting. Excuse me, I just ate ramen. I do the tip of my nose and then my Cupid's bow. This is like a very light powder. As you can see, like it's like yellow, the lightest one. So I go in with my beauty blender and I just kind of like pat it out. I even do up here. I just kind of like pat it into my skin just so it's not so powdery on top of my skin, because I won't set it because it won't have the same glow. So I just do that so it's not like, I don't know how to describe it, just like a, you can't see like the product like on my skin. Like if I had just left it, would have just been like a strip of powder like sitting on top of my skin. And not that anyone probably would have noticed that, but I know it's there, so I would have been upset about it. So I just mix Dipping Gold and the Sunburst, the lightest shade, and I'm just packing that under my eyebrow with a brush that I will tell you about. Let's cursive. And I never learned cursive, so I can't read it, but I got this in an Ipsy box. It's just like a random eyeshadow brush. You can use any brush. It doesn't really need to be like specific for your under your eyebrow. But I also go in the corner of my eyes, as you can see, just to draw some attention to the inner corner. This will mix a little bit with the color under my lashes, so it like turns like a light pink, even though it's not light pink in the slightest. So we are almost done. Now I have to brush out my eyelashes. Normally they'd be looking fire, but I waited way too long for a fill. So I just brush them down. And then I puff them up. And they're looking crazy. You can just kind of like push them around. Like I have a huge gap like right here, so I'm just trying to like push them around to fill in the gap. Okay, I thought we were almost done. We are. So I have the ABH brow gel. Looks like this. It's just a clear brow gel. Go in with a very light hand and just kind of make sure these bad boys stay in place. And I just kind of tap off the extra gel, so I don't, if you put too much on, it gets kind of like a white residue. Like it gets kind of like crunchy. It's not very cute. So I try to avoid using a lot. But that is that. I don't use anything for my brows. Like I said, brows and eyelashes are like the two supposed to be like fun like parts of your makeup routine that like bring everything together, and I don't do anything to either of mine, so not too much of a glow up from what I looked like before. I don't use any lip product because I like the natural color of my lips. So I go in with Aquaphor chapstick, and that's my lip gloss for tonight. Nice and moisturized. And it's still shiny. We're done, finally. Alrighty, we have moved into my bathroom where the lighting is not ideal. There's only one light that controls this light, and then the light that has the room right here. The door's closed. There's like the toilet and the shower. This is just like our sink area. So the light
switch there that controls this light controls that light as well, which has a fan in it. So that annoying noise in the background is the fan. I cannot shut it off, so. I am going to straighten my hair. This is my natural hair. I showered like around noonish, and I just let my hair air dry. And it looks like this. Just brush through it. It's pretty straight to begin with. I don't straighten my whole head. I just straighten like the front pieces, like this part, because I have the habit of like tucking my hair behind my ears like this. So it gets, there's like a wave like right there. It's crazy. I've always done that. It's been like a habit. So that's just what I do. So this is like the final hair look. Literally just straight. So boring. But you can see it just like, it's like noticeably thicker. It feels thicker, like you can feel the difference. But I'll show you. You can see like right there. Like that's my real hair right here. And then this is the fake hair. So it's literally a difference of what? Like an inch, 2 inches in length. But it makes so much of it, like so much, even just those two little pieces makes such a difference when it comes to like just the thickness, like how it feels, like it just feels heavier. I don't know, I like it. That's my hair, if you guys were wondering. Like I said, if you guys are curious about like an extension tutorial and more about that, let me know and I'll do a video on that, because when you buy the extensions, they don't come with the clips in. Like you have to sew the clip, you have to buy the clips, you have to buy the yarn and the needle. And then like you just get like a roll of hair. So it's like a piece of fabric. Like you just get a roll of hair and you have to measure it and then sew the clips in and yada yada. So if you guys are like curious how I went about that and like the research and color match and all that stuff, like let me know. I'll do a video literally just on my hair extensions. But that's that. Now to the outfit. Okay, so we're gonna see how far we can back up here. I'm so far away. This is the final fit. I'm gonna do like a mirror capture, like a version in the mirror, so you guys can see my shoes as well, because I don't think you can see my shoes very well. But yes, this is what I've chose for tonight. Kind of some comfy cargo pants. And just like a straight across tank top. So this top is a ribbed material. It's pretty thick. Oh my gosh, that ramen, my indigestion is just not happening, sorry. But yeah, it's kind of like a ribbed material. Goes straight across. This is from Misguided. I can link this in the description box. Hopefully they still have it. I got it like last spring. They don't usually switch up their basics like this very often, so it should still be on there. I'm not sure how much I got this for. It's definitely on sale. I only buy stuff that's like on sale. And then the pants, these are just some cargo pants. I don't know if you can like try to back up. They have pockets on the back. They have a couple pockets. Great for all your belongings that you want to bring to a party. You have plenty of room. I don't know that this came with a chain, but I took a chain off like another pair of cargo pants that I had bought. These are from Fashion Nova. They are a size 4. And I got them on sale. I know they were like $20. For shoes. You can see. It's like those videos. Oh my god, wait, I'm gonna stand on a chair. This guy. Oh god, I almost busted my ass. Okay. You still can't see it. I can't win. Here, wait. Maybe if I hold on. It's a rocking chair. It's like my desk chair, so it's kind of dangerous. You can kind of see. Okay, but yeah, this is the final look. It's a black beanbag behind me, so you can't really see the shoes as well. But yeah, these are the shoes. The pants, my chain. That is the final look. It's my cute little living room.
But yeah, so I'm gonna go out now. I hope you guys enjoyed this. And if you wanna see more videos like this, let me know. If you have any other video ideas or you like any of the other video ideas that I mentioned, please let me know. I loved all the support and love that I got in my last video, so thank you guys, I appreciate it. So yeah, we're gonna go now. Bye. Okay guys, so I just wanted to do like, here, I'm gonna stand up because the light's better. I wanted to do just a short little outro, but I do really want to like thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. With all the support with my last video, it meant so much, like everyone just being like supportive and watching and sending me videos of them watching or telling me that they watched and liked it. Like that meant so much to me. It's still so new, it's still like bittersweet. Like I'm still kind of like uncomfortable with the fact of people being like, oh my gosh, I watched your video. I'm like, really, why? No, but I do appreciate it. Hopefully I'm gonna be getting in a better routine, like uploading and filming and stuff like that. Once again, it's just so hard to like find the time. Being a full-time student and working part-time, it's just a lot, but I appreciate you guys watching. I hope this video is enjoyable and entertaining. I tried, I talked a lot, so if you guys don't like that, let me know. If you wanna see more videos like this, or you have other video ideas, let me know. But yeah, I'm gonna go have a great night with my girls, and I hope you guys as well, if you're watching it at night, or if you watch it in the morning, good morning. Hopefully this will give you a great kickstart to your day. But yeah, I'm gonna go now, but thank you guys.